Good afternoon, everyone. It's about 5 to 4. I'm David Paul. Welcome to our vectorVest webcast. We'll be speaking about worry-free investing. So, folks, we're going to talk about the most conservative form of investing on vectorVest. We refer to it as worry-free investing. Those of you that feel you are aggressive traders, I wouldn't worry, because the approach has in fact made a great deal of money over the last few years. I've tested it and back-tested it over the years. I haven't done any back-testing for the last 3 or 4 years with the approach. That's because I've been trading it personally with real money, my own money, and it's been an exceptionally good time. So before we can do anything, those of you that are vectorVest subscribers, and there's quite a few in the room, great to see you. You'll know about the disclaimer. Those of you that are not vectorVest subscribers, welcome. we are pretty much the only education company and software provider in the United Kingdom that's in fact authorized by the regulator, the FCA. And although I'm qualified to give financial advice, I can't do so because I haven't sat down with you and done a long and detailed fact find. I'm allowed to talk about those shares that I hold myself, but I have to make it very clear that although those shares are suitable for me, they may not be suitable for you. Okay, so once I've said that, we can move on to more interesting things. So my objective, folks, is to show you how to invest with confidence and outperform the market in a few minutes a day. Now, let me make it very clear, because I've confused people in the past. This is not day trading. I'm not talking about buying the London market at 9 o'clock and selling it at 10 past nine. Nothing could be further from the truth. We want you to get you to a point where you can actually buy into a portfolio of stocks and manage those stocks in a few minutes a day. Most days, there's nothing to do. Okay. And the objective is to show you how to retire younger with more loot than you ever thought you could by three things. Let me get my pen. The first thing may seem obvious, but it's capital growth. We want to buy shares that are going to rise in price. That may seem obvious. The second thing is that we want to buy shares that are going to pay us a dividend. And hopefully, we can reinvest that dividend into the mix. Now, I have a PhD in mathematics, so when I sit down in Excel and do those compounding sums, adding in a 3 to 5% dividend into the mix, I'm incredibly impressed of how money grows, and Einstein said it was one of the wonders of the world, compounding. And the third thing that we can build wealth with, and this is really, really difficult in the UK, very easy in the US, is by actually writing covered calls on the shares that you own. And by doing so, building an income, a very low risk income that you can also put back into the mix. Now, out of the US, writing options at the retail level is really, really difficult, if not impossible, in the UK. That wasn't always the case 20 years ago when Life was running, the London International Financial Futures Exchange, which used to run in Cannon Bridge, where IG Index is at the minute. There was a thriving options market, but when Life was sold, that options market in the UK pretty much crumbled. I think that you can buy calls and you can buy puts on a few top UK stocks like Shell, etc. But to actually write options for income is pretty much a US thing. So we're going to build wealth by number one and number two. And that's what I'm going to try and show you. So why am I here? Well, that's yours truly. Those people that are watching me on YouTube can see a little picture of me in the bottom left-hand corner. Unfortunately, a day or two away from 66. That photograph taken, well, 2 years ago, just before the last Christmas where we could fly, we could go somewhere. So taken on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange. I have an awful lot of good friends who are brokers on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange. In fact, traders that I taught over the years, South Africans. My background is I've got a degree in engineering. I've got an MSc in metallurgy. I've got a PhD in applied mathematics. And in 1980, I was playing nearly international level rugby, and I went to South Africa to play rugby professionally. I actually went for 6 months to play for a provincial side called Transvaal, and I ended up staying 35 years. Some cynic at a seminar some years ago said, did they play extra time? But when I was in South Africa, I started to trade in the Johannesburg Stock Exchange, and that's where I met most of these guys. For the last 10 years, I've been, in fact, showing people how to improve their performance using vectorVest, initially in South Africa, and then I came back to the UK to run vectorVest UK. I came back permanently to the UK 5 years now, so I've been fully back at home, really, for the last 5 years. So that's my background. So what we're going to try and cover, and I don't want to keep you too long, is one, the vectorVest system of analyzing stocks. And during the presentation, folks, I tend to use the word shares and stocks interchangeably, okay? The second thing that we're going to try and cover is market timing. Now, that's a very controversial subject. And market timing, many people say that it's time in the market, not timing the market, that's important. But at vectorVest, we believe that there's a really great time to be in the stock market, and there's an awful time to be in the stock market. In this part of the presentation, we're going to try and identify simply and easily when it's safe to be in the stock market. And then what I'm going to try and do is to fuse it all together into a very simple and safe and robust worry-free investing strategy. All right, and that's a hell of a tall order in a few minutes. I think you can hear the helicopter in the background. There's a huge march underway in London today. So helicopters, there's a half a dozen of them in the sky. The vectorVest system for analyzing stocks and the three magic words, folks. If you're in the property market, three magic words. Location, 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 they say. Well, if you're in the stock market, three magic words as well. Earnings, profits, inflation in the economy, and interest rates in the economy. And if you've been reading any of the financial press recently, inflation is a huge worry. And certainly during the course of this week in both the UK and the USA, inflation figures broke up through highs. Okay, so if inflation goes up, interest rates go up. That, in fact, reduces the stock's valuation. So three magic words, and you can see the downward pressure on stock prices that we've seen over the last 6 weeks now due to inflation fears. That really came very clearly, not last Monday, but the Monday before, when the market broke down very strongly indeed. And that happened, in fact, when I was doing my Monday afternoon Q&A session. And I'll be doing another session this Monday afternoon at a very, very important juncture for the American market as well. We'll be there live as it takes place. So at vectorVest, folks, we believe that every investor should know, what's a stock really worth? And we favor undervalued shares. How safe is the earnings stream? And when to buy, sell, or hold? Is the share rising? Is it going nowhere and we're sweating it out, or is it falling? Now, this afternoon, we're going to focus on the most conservative vectorVest trading plan called worry-free investing. And in worry-free investing, ladies and gentlemen, we want, if I can use a rugby metaphor, we want the ball to do the work. And we're going to focus on shares that have got a very safe track record of making money, that can also grow their earnings. And these are very, very special stocks, and there's not that many of them on the London market. Shares that have got a strong track record of safely growing profits. And as a result, I'm really going to spend an awful lot of time focusing on the safety and the predictability of the earnings stream. So the very first vectorVest metric, and I believe the most important vectorVest metric, is called relative value. And in relative value, as the slide says, it's an indicator of the long-term price appreciation potential. Now, for long-term, read 3 years. In relation to what a corporate bond will pay over the same period. And the corporate bond is our measure of the risk-free rate. So here's how we do that. We forecast the profits or the earnings of every company on the London stock market for the next 3 years. So we forecast what's it going to make next year, what's it going to make the year after that, what's it going to make the year after that. We make the following assumption. We assume that those earnings will be discounted into the price at some time within that 3-year window. And we work out what the price will be. We take that projected price and we subtract the price today to get the upside. And we divide that upside by what a corporate bond will pay in the same period. And the resultant, ladies and gentlemen, is relative value. It's a prediction of the future. Now, everything on vectorVest runs between 0 and 2. If the RV, relative value, is less than 1, that's not good. Because it has a high probability of underperforming the money that you'll get from a corporate bond. Now, if you have any idea about the company pecking order, the bondholders get paid well before the common shareholders. So, ladies and gentlemen, you'd be taking a risk in something as intrinsically risky as a share for a reward which is less than what a corporate bond will pay, and that's not smart. If the relative value is greater than 1, that's not bad, fair. And ladies and gentlemen, we have in fact ascertained that if the relative value is greater than 1.25, then the share price growth is strong enough to meet our capital growth requirements within worry-free investing. So my very first requirement for a worry-free share is that the relative value must be greater than 1.25. In other words, it in fact must outperform a corporate bond by 25%. Now, I've tested this, our customers have tested this, and certainly including an RV greater than 1.25 makes a huge difference in the ability of that portfolio to appreciate capital growth. And that's the first leg of us being able to get wealthy out of worry-free investing. Now, the relative value is a number that answers a question that's been around in trading and investing since trading investing started. The normal measure of valuation of a share is called PE, the price of the share divided by how much money it makes. And ladies and gentlemen, this is in fact a measure of the number of years it takes for you to get your money back after you buy the share. So a share that's on a PE of 10 means its price is 10 times that of its earnings. It's going to take 10 years for you to get your money back. Now, the big question in investing, is it better to buy a share on a PE of 5 or a PE of 80? Now, a simple-minded analysis would say that a PE of 5 is much, much better because you're buying this company for 5 times earnings. Whereas with the other example, you'd be paying 80 times earnings. But there was a trader of yesteryear called William Delbert Gann, and old Gann used to say, if it's that obvious, it's obviously wrong. Unfortunately, PE doesn't help you much because it's looking back. A share with a PE of 80 could be growing earnings really, really, really fast. And in fact, at a PE of 80, it's a snip in relation to its future profit potential. And that's been the case with a share like Amazon forever. That's been had a huge PE that just kept on rising. Now, similarly, a share on a PE of 5 may seem a bargain, but if those earnings are falling off a cliff, it's far from being a bargain. And that, in fact, happened to a very good friend of mine. He's a fund manager. He ran the investments for a large listed company, listed both in London and Johannesburg. And he started up his own shop, and he fell in love with the share that we all do from time to time, and he kept buying more and more of it on a PE of 5 because he thought it was a bargain. It was on a PE of 5 for a very good reason. The share was going broke, and out of that, he in fact lost his company. If you've ever managed money, and I've managed an awful lot of money for people over the years, if you've ever managed money, you'll realize that if you've got a holding that goes bankrupt on you, the clients run for the door. Relative value answers that question immediately. Is it better to buy, which is the best? The one on 5, the one on 80? And of course, one of the best bargains out there, and there's not that many of those, would be a share that's got a high relative value and a low PE. That's a really great place to look. And those of you that are vectorVest subscribers, just have a look at Sylvania Platinum, okay? In fact, has both those attributes. So in worry-free investing, our first characteristic, ladies and gentlemen, is that I want the RV to be greater than 1.25. Our room has greatly expanded since I, in fact, did my welcome. So welcome to everyone. That's great, folks. I see Calvin's here from Wales. Charles is here. We've even got Stan Heller from Canada. Hello, Stan. I should have made you a presenter, sir. Honored to have you here. Welcome, everyone. Those of you that I didn't welcome at the outset, I've got there's a dozen helicopters in the air here in central London. There is a huge march. It's just chaos out there today. Absolute chaos on the streets. The second metric, folks, and this is the one that I'm really going to focus on today, is relative safety. And as you can see, this measures the consistency and the predictability of the financial performance. So what vectorVest does, and what Dr. Leder's algorithm does, is that it looks at the balance sheet, the income statement, the cash flow statement. It looks at sales, looks at margins, it looks at dividends, dividend growth, dividend safety of every company in the database, 2,200 companies. It sucks in all those numbers and spits out one number, which measures, as the slide says, the consistency and the predictability of the financial performance. Now, again, everything's between 0 and 2. Less than 1, not good. This is a company where the financial numbers have been up and down. Could be okay for a short-term speculation where you're managing risk proactively with tight stop-loss orders. But for a worry-free stock, we want to give those a very wide berth. And the wonderful words of Charlie Munger, Buffett's partner of many years, they're too hard. Okay, too hard. Simple as that. Greater than 1 is not bad. And ladies and gentlemen, if you've got a stock on a relative safety of greater than 1.3, that's the share that's making money. And all those ghastly financial ratios, I'm still a mechanical engineer, are getting better. It pays a dividend and has got a history of growing that dividend safely. And that's the second requirement of our worry-free trading plan. And in fact, in the little uni-search that I put up in a few minutes, I'm going to sort all of the stocks in the London stock market by relative safety to bring the safest stocks to the top of the pile. So ladies and gentlemen, what I'm trying to get at here is that I want to find a stock that's got the ability to grow earnings strongly and thus satisfy our capital gains part of our wealth creation plan. And to do that, they should have a relative value of greater than 1.25. And they should have a history of making money safely. So we can safely let the ball do the work without a great deal of stress. And that means that I want a relative safety up around the 1.3 level. And as I say, there are very few of those on the London stock market. Many more on the US market, because it's 4 or 5 times as big. There are enough on the London stock market, and they've stood us in very, very good stead since the lows way back last March. The third vectorVest metric is called relative timing, which measures the short-term price trend of the share. This is a relatively simple number to compute. And if we were doing a talk on momentum investing or swing trading, it's vitally important. Not that important for today's discussion. And then what Dr. Leder did is that he sorted all of the shares on the London stock market by this combination of RV and RS, which are fundamental measures of the share, and RT, which is a technical measure of the share. Now, my definition of fundamental analysis is it's the search for the true value of a share. And my definition of technical analysis is it's the study of trends and turning points. Now, if you go to an investment meeting, the fundamental analysts will be sitting in one corner of the room, and the technical analyst will be sitting in the other corner of the room. The technical analyst pretty much thinks that the fundamental analyst is reacting to numbers that are 6 months to a year old. And of course, the fundamental analyst thinks that the technical analyst is reading the tea leaves, so there's not a lot of common ground there. Until the second drink, and then they throw abuse at each other for the rest of the evening. It can get very nasty. So here was this guy, he's got a PhD in chemical engineering, and he said, I just want to make some money here. And what he did is that he put a relative value and relative safety, a fundamental measure, together with relative timing. And thus, combined fundamental analysis and technical analysis into the one single number. I'd never seen that done before. As a default, all of the shares in the London stock market are sorted by VST. I'll show you that in a minute. As I say, this VST combines both fundamental and technical analysis. Now, as this is a presentation which focuses on hands-off, I'm in fact going to sort all of the shares later this afternoon by relative safety alone, to bring the safest stocks to the top of the pile. Again, those of you that are feel that you are aggressive traders, don't allow yourself to be put off. This methodology has produced a 50%+ return over the last year. Not many day traders sitting in front of 5-minute charts have done that. Most of them have gone broke. Just look at the IG stats. We calculate the stop loss for every share in the market every single day. Now, the stop loss is loosely based on a 13-week moving average, 65-day moving average. But it's adjusted, folks, for the fundamentals. And the fundamentals are summarized by RV and RS. Now, in our worry-free methodology, we're going to be looking at high RV and high RS only. And thus, the stop loss is moved away. We actually give shares with outstanding fundamentals more room to move. The vectorVest stop loss is weaving a very, very fine line between keeping you in a winning position and protecting your capital. Now, those of you that have been in markets for a while will know that before every half decent move, the market will go the other way and do its best to run your stops. And we've had, I remember some years back out at our Oxford group, we had a young man there who was in tears for a day because before JD Sports, in fact, had made a 40% move, it had gone back for one day, broke down below a 20-day low, where there tends to be an awful lot of stops sitting below a 20-day low. And was down there for about 15 minutes, soaked up all that liquidity, and then blasted off the other way, and he got stopped out. Now, the vectorVest stop loss is placed well out of the traffic. It's not perfect. No stop loss placement is perfect, but it gets a long way to keeping you in those big moves. Okay, and we use the vectorVest stop loss, at least I use the vectorVest stop loss for our worry-free trading plan. And finally, in terms of definitions, we put a buy, sell, or hold to every share in the market every single day. Largely, folks, this is a trend-following signal. The only fundamental input for a buy is that the VST must be greater than 1. Clearly, the sell is obvious. The price closes below the stop price, and hold is somewhere in between. Now, for our worry-free trading plan, we don't want shares that are below their stop loss. So we're going to look at shares on a buy, some on shares that are slugging it out on a hold. So before I go to market direction, I'm going to actually discard all my drawings. I'm going to go to the vectorVest program itself. Now, that's the front page of vectorVest from yesterday, the close yesterday. I'm going to go through this in a second. But I want to go to viewers. And this is the stock viewer. So when you go into this for the first time, you've got to click on Stock Viewer to populate the spreadsheet. As you can see, we're following 2,063 shares on the London market and on AIM. As a default, all of the shares are sorted by VST, but if you want to sort by RS, you just click this button and it will sort it by RS in a second. So at the top, we've got Cape Tech. And Cape Tech is trading at 330. Dr. DeLeto's valuation algorithm, in fact, says that it's worth 444. So it's undervalued. It was up 2.5 pence yesterday. The valuation is a proprietary vectorVest calculation. The 250, clearly you can get that from the paper. That's not proprietary information. Now, the first really, really important number, folks, is RV. Now, remember RV, that magic number that looks to the future. It's saying that this company is going to outperform a corporate bond by 58% over the next 3 years. Now, anything above 1.3 is excellent. And I have a figure for 1.58 that the vectorVest regulars will recognize. It's called Bloody Marvelous. That's a really cracking number. The relative safety, folks, is 1.19. Now, that's certainly fair to good. It's on the low side for a worry-free stock. It really is. Nevertheless, this number is quite good. You could give it the benefit of the doubt. I haven't, but you could. I like to see my RS above 1.25. I've managed money for people for a long time, folks. And this RS is a magic number if you want to keep clients happy, okay? And you want to keep your wife happy, and you want to keep your, you don't want to end up with a hairstyle like mine, okay? Relative safety as high as possible. Doesn't eliminate mistakes or surprises, but it certainly reduces them to a very manageable level. RT's 1.89, saying on a scale between 0 and 2, this thing is pretty much going up vertically. And we put all three together, folks, we've got the highest VST in the pack. Not surprisingly, it's on a buy recommendation. Stop loss is 281. Now, I didn't get time to talk about this. If you come to my Monday afternoon sessions, that's called the CI, which I think if you call the CI the long-term trend, and RT, the short-term trend, well, you're getting that. That's pretty much what it is. It's called the Comfort Index. And this GRT measures the percentage annualized growth rate of the share next year. This is 32%. It's on a PE of 24. And if you go to the right-hand side, there's all sorts of dividend information here. So this is a really good-looking stock. We've been looking at it on Monday afternoons for a long time. It's in an interesting sector of the market, which is cybersecurity, sector looking good worldwide. Let's have a look at the chart. There we go. That's the chart. The blue line, let me make it a bit bigger, is earnings per share. And that is our forecast of earnings per share. And over the last year I've got open, earnings per share has gone up from 9p to 14p. So that's pretty much a 50%, more than a 50% growth in earnings per share. And as Ben Graham said, now Ben Graham was a professor of economics and he was Buffett's mentor. And so he has to be taken seriously. He's written some wonderful books on long-term investing. And he says that earnings per share growth is the engine that drives the share price. Now, one of the things that I've been taught at vectorVest over the years is that the smoother this earnings per share plot is, the easier it is to make some money. And as you can see, this share surprised the market here. You see this gap? Okay, that's a surprise. The only gap when when a news comes out. So this is a relatively small company. That's one of the beauties of the stock market. There are many, many companies out there that none of the big boys know anything about. They just haven't got the resources to look at them. And we know more about these smaller companies than many of the big, big investment houses. But certainly this woke a lot of people up here. So it moved up here. As you can see, it's on a vectorVest buy from right across here. Okay. We looked at this last Monday afternoon, in fact, in our Monday afternoon Q&A, this looked like a pretty much cert to move. Our valuation is, where am I going? I've done something dumb. Our valuation's right up here, folks, at 450. Now, that's not a target, but I reckon that's got legs in it up to about the £4 level. That's an example. Down below, we've got volume here. That's my standard chart, not volume all the time. I'm looking for earnings per share. I want to see earnings per share moving up from bottom left to top right. You can just simply buy breakouts. This gap is always a very positive move. And those of you that have done some of my short-term stuff, I have a name for a gap out of a consolidation like that. It's called the rocket launcher. The rocket launcher would simply have bought this share here with a stop loss under there. That would have been a move from 250 to 330, which can't be sniffed at in a week or two. So Cape Tech looks good, but the RS maybe a tad low. Now, Future is trading at about valuation. It's on RV of 1.54, which is right up in the bloody marvelous category. But this time we've got an RS of 1.26. Now that's starting to become very acceptable indeed. RT is 1.8, which means it's going up fast. And the VST is 1.56. There's the stop. Long-term trend is outstanding. If you're a technician, folks, anybody listening who are primarily technicians, you'll find that this CI does most of your technical analysis for you automatically. If you want to find all of the shares in the London stock market that are trending strongly over a period of the last couple of years, you just sort the whole darn market by CI and you've got them in a second. That is a fast route to profitability on its own. Growth rate, 36%. PE of about 30. So this share has been on the radar for a long time. And that's what it's done in the last little period. Again, we see this gap. Look at this earnings per share number. And this share's had a cracking run over the last 5 years. So it was losing money until the current MD came in. And that's COVID, that's for sure. And moving up. And I think there's an awful lot more left in this stock. I wouldn't want to buy it at the minute after that run. But certainly, if it got back down to 25, I'd be interested in it. So we have a lovely lady that runs our London upper London group, Susan Thornborough. And Susan has been using vectorVest longer than I have. She started with vectorVest Australia, and like me, she'd been out of the country for a long time. She's Manchester initially, and she came back to the UK to take care of her mum. Like me, she's now permanently back here. I don't think she'll go much further now, although I speaking out of turn. She just looks at the stock viewer to find her stocks. And she just eyeballs them in the way that we've done. And she does it incredibly well. And on our Monday afternoon sessions and on our national user group, she shows everybody how she does that in seconds. But as we'll see in a moment, we can go to UniSearch, and UniSearch will do all of that automatically. So in UniSearch, we can ask for an RV of greater than 1.25. We can ask for a high RS. We can ask for a certain dividend yield if we wish. We can ask for a certain liquidity if we wish. So that's what we're going to do in a moment. We're going to use the power of Unisearch to find some shares that look great. I've had a great run in Games Workshop. And as you can see, the RV is 1.43. RS is 1.47, growth rate of 23. The CI is 1.58. Great numbers. And this to me looks as if it's heading towards heaven, folks. That's the share. And we look at it. The last tranche I bought, well, that's not true. I started to buy back into it somewhere around here last April. Show you exactly when, just there. It's gone sideways for a long time. I added to it here and I added to it here again. I talk about that every Monday afternoon. You see all the trades, warts and all. To me, this looks as if it's just about to break higher. If it can get through these highs, then it will leave all the overhead resistance behind. An exceptionally good update. Came out on Friday, so I'm very, very pleased with Games Workshop. Games Workshop's been in our arsenal, folks, right back since it was £12, and it's now 147, 114. And I sat on an investment meeting at an investment show way back in about 2014. And I was asked what was my top stock pick for this year, and I said Games Workshop. And the chap who was running it, he was running the panel that I was on, he laughed at me. He said I was buying into a company that made toy soldiers. Well, they make much, much more than toy soldiers these days. So, that's been absolutely great. Looks to me as if it's just about to go again. If I wasn't so big in it, I would buy some more. Let me now go back to the rest of my presentation because I don't want to keep you here all day. How to accurately determine market direction? Well, as I say, this is controversial. Now, we believe that there's a great time to be in a market and an awful time to be in the market. In fact, I take it further and I tell everybody who listens to me that I believe that 70% of the exercise is in fact knowing whether the market is rising or falling. Everything follows from that. And the mantra at vectorVest is buying rising stocks and rising markets. Now, if it was another webcast and we were being much, much more aggressive, we could also sell falling stocks and falling markets called shorting. But I'm not talking about that today. And those of you that want to have a go at it, just remember that you've got to be better on the short side. Nobody believes me when I tell them that until they have a go themselves. But you've got to be better on the short side. You're competing against a completely different player, I assure you. We're going to confine ourselves to buying rising safe stocks in rising markets. And Dr. DeLito puts it well, being on the wrong side of the market is the worst thing that can happen to you. It doesn't have to happen to you. And that's a quote from his book, Stock Strategies and Common Sense, which you can download. And I'll show you where you can get it in a moment. But we're told by everybody on the television, on the newspapers, I read it this morning in the paper, to ignore market direction. And this was first brought to me by a story my father told me. He told me that in 1969, the London market made a low. It took 21 years, folks, for the London market to get above that low in real money. So what happened in 69, the market made a high, and then it fell right into 1981. The low was in 81. So there was a bear market that lasted, 12 years. And then it took from 81 to 90 to break the 69 high. So I don't know about you, but I haven't got 21 years to wait. Similarly, the market, our market, the London market, made a high on the 1st of January 2000. And now we're in May 2021. So we're a year and a half, and we're about 21 years later. And it's a few hundred points higher than it was then. But along the way, the market's made some great moves. It went down to 2003, went right up to 2007, fell out of bed onto March the 9th, 2009, ingrained on my soul. Then it ran, and it's still running, apart from the COVID and the Euro crisis pullbacks. So some great moves. But if you had sat the whole time, okay, if you had added in the dividends, you've done okay. But my word, you could have done so much more. And this is a simple metaphor for a stock market. I haven't been on one of these damn things in 40 years. But what I can remember is that they take a long time to get up there. And they fall very quickly. Has anybody been on one of these more recently than 40 years? You've got a full room. Anybody been on these more recently than 40 years? Stan, have you been on one more recently than 40 years? And that's what they were like the last time I was on one of them. I've got only one person here. Charles says no. No, Charles, anyway, at least you can hear me. That's what I was really checking on. So we're told by everybody that buy and hold is the way to go. So let's just look. And I want to go to the front page of vectorVest because it's a little bit bigger there from experience. So if I go to home, right. The front page of vectorVest, folks, is designed to give you all the information that you need. And it's designed with these little boxes, and you can place whatever boxes you want in there within reason. So you can see whatever you want to see. And I've loaded the default. Now, I could spend a very, very long time on the front page of vectorVest, and we've got navigation videos that will help you with that. But to answer the question of is the market rising or falling, we've simplified that, especially for those people who don't like charts. Now, I know there are people who just don't want to be bothered looking at charts. I personally like looking at charts, but there are people who just couldn't be bothered. And I have no problems with that. The two most important words on vectorVest are these two, under trend. Up and up. And these measure the direction of the vectorVest composite, which is our own composite indicator of the entire London market based on the 2,200 shares that we follow. I'm going to show you it in a moment. Now, the trend situation as the close last night is up and up. The first word refers to the short-term trend of the vectorVest market, of the vectorVest composite. And the second word refers to the underlying trend of the vectorVest composite. Now, let me just simplify because many people have told me they don't understand the difference between short-term and long-term trend. If you think of it as two boats, a small little launch and our aircraft carrier, the Queen Elizabeth. I think you would agree that the small little boat can duck back and forward much, much more quickly than the Queen Elizabeth. And similarly, the short-term trend can bounce back and forward in relation to short-term moves of the vectorVest composite. And the underlying trend smooths out that short-term noise. It doesn't see that short-term noise. So two measures of the trend. And on Friday, at the close, the short-term trend, the first word, was up. And the underlying trend, the second word, was up. Now, for the basis of our discussion, the most important market timing signal is this confirmed up. And that's what we use for our worry-free investing. And the confirmed up is no more than the underlying trend confirmed by 2 weeks price action. So this confirmed up has been in place since the 11th of November last year. So it smooths out a great deal of noise. So if you were a worry-free investor, you were safely sitting in the stock market in shares that have got the ability to grow earnings strongly and safely since last November. The traffic light represents the strength, resilience, and momentum of the short-term trend. And to do that, it looks at the price of the vectorVest composite, it looks at the momentum, the RT of the vectorVest composite, and it also looks at what we call the buy-sell ratio, which is the number of shares on a buy divided by the number of shares on a sell. It sums those all up into this traffic light, and based on the traffic light, it gives advice. And the advice, vectorVest advocates buying safe, undervalued stocks that are rising in price at this time. Now, years back, when we were evolving this technique, we were scratching our heads to decide on what timing signal we would use for worry-free investing. And Calvin, who's in the room today, came up with the following. He said that to buy in, we must have a confirmed up, and this pointer should be well into the green, and the advice positive. So we want, ladies and gentlemen, both boats to be heading in the one way. In other words, the small boat and the Queen Elizabeth are pointing the one way, and the small boat is speeding up. And that's what we've adopted over the last years, and it's worked very well. So that's the confirmed up, that's been in place. Now, let me show you the vectorVest composite. If I click on timing, go to the market timing graph itself and pull this up. Now I'm showing you the vectorVest composite. There's an awful lot of indicators that fit on this, but I'm just showing you the raw vectorVest composite. And remember, if you don't like looking at charts, it's all summarized on the front page of vectorVest. You don't need to look at this, and clearly vectorVest comes with a magnificent app these days, and it's on your phone. So I don't care where you are, you've got time every day to have a look at whether the market is rising or falling, and say nothing much has changed since November. Now, down below here, we've got all of the vectorVest market timing systems. Confirmed calls are the longest term measure of the trend, and that's what we use on worry-free investing. The primary wave, that's the small boat. That's the noisiest measure of the trend. The DEW is a medium term market timing system that I use for my swing trades. And these are also short term methods that we haven't got time to discuss today. So if I click on confirmed calls, this automatically places red and green triangles on the chart. This is the last 15 months since last February when COVID hit us. So we can go back a bit further to, there we go. That's the start of, that is the 24th of October, 2019. We had this move up. That lasted what? 5 months, November to February, yeah, something like that, 4 months. We then got this signal that the market was falling, and I think that was a great signal here in February. The market rising here. We had a little speed bump here, came to nothing. And all of a sudden, since the 11th of November, market has been rising. In this little bit here, the short-term trend was down, but the longer-term trend never moved, didn't budge. Ladies and gentlemen, worry-free investing is simple. When we've got a green triangle, I want to be fully invested in shares that are growing their earnings strongly and safely, that have got a high RV greater than 1.25 and a high RS up around the 1.3 level, that have got sufficient liquidity for our position. In other words, you can get in and out easily. Now, I was pretty much, I have been fully invested since this period. But sooner or later, you get a red one. Now, sooner or later, we're going to get one of these reds. Markets are like that. They breathe in and they breathe out, folks, just like any other human being. So what do we do when we get a red triangle? Well, we simply do nothing. We watch our stop losses very carefully. If the general market is falling, then there's a much higher probability that you're going to get stopped out, even of a high RS stock. But testing proves conclusively that it's much, much better to sit in and watch your stop losses carefully. Because in this little move here, this pullback, I wasn't stopped out of anything. So largely, the same shares that I bought down here are still running. Unfortunately, in the next red triangle, we don't know if it's one of these ones or one of these ones. And I assure you, in November, things were bad enough. That was when we were going into that darn second lockdown that lasted 4 months. That's when the Kent variant was scaring the living daylights out of us. So in this pullback that happened in November, I didn't get stopped out of anything at all. In this one that happened in February, I got stopped out of everything. Every damn thing. And that was quite a morning. That's the first time that's happened since 2007. If we go back now, and let's look at a typical year. Look at this. This was 2019. Got our first signal to buy in at the start of 2019. In 2018, folks, Paul said he was going to put up interest rates in the US. And I talked earlier about the effect of interest rates. In fact, he changed his mind completely. And I think that was the biggest turnaround in policy from the Fed that I've ever seen. That was Christmas 2018. That was the Christmas I was in New York City. I've been fully invested from here. And then we got red triangles. Now, in these two red triangles, we weren't stopped out of anything. When you get a red triangle, you've got to be much, much more diligent on your stop losses. Because you don't know, is it one of these? Or one of these small ones. You just don't know. And there's an awful lot of people on the internet who say they do know. But folks, they would not be selling newsletters if they knew. I assure you. They would be in a full tilt. So in August of 2019, I got stopped out of two positions in that move in August. I got back in, fully invested at the next green, and this one, in fact, didn't cause any problems to the high RS stocks at all. So in the whole of 2019, I made two trades, that's all. And then, of course, in February, end of February 2020, I had to get out of them all. I went back in here in cash. With cash, full cash. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you get a red signal, that is a signal to you to watch your stop losses carefully. Now, you don't have to look at charts. That'll be on the front page of vectorVest where you saw the confirmed up. That'll, in fact, show confirmed down. When you see that, you need to be much, much more diligent on your stop losses. Now, when I see a red triangle, here's what I do. One, no more buys. Two, watch the stop losses in the shares that you've got very carefully. And three, have a look at your portfolio and look at some stocks that have done nothing in the last run-up. I get rid of those and raise some cash. So those are the three things that I do so that I've got some money left for the next up signal. And that's the process. I'll explain the process a little bit later, but I need to move on. Any questions about the process? It couldn't be simpler, really. Those of you that think this is a too conservative approach, from the start of 2019, this portfolio was up 45%. And of course, I give 15% back here. So from there to there, I was up 30%. And from this low, we're up 50% already. So that's 30 and 50 over the last couple of years. And I've pretty much done nothing. In fact, sometimes it's so embarrassing on Monday afternoons that I haven't done anything, that I've got to liven up the proceedings with some swing trades. We're letting the bull do the work in the UK's safest shares. Shares that have got the ability to grow their earnings safely. It's a great place to be. So let's have a look at how we do this. How to build and manage a worry-free portfolio. We've got a question here. Yes, Ramesh, that's for sure. You don't know whether it's one, you don't know whether it's just a simple pullback, Ramesh, or whether you've got a situation like what happened last February, okay? That's always a difficult one, Ash. It's always best, Ash says, do we wait for the next signal or we get in now? I'm actively going to add to positions now, Ash, if that answers that question for you. So I'll be buying. I bought into one last week, in fact. So I will be buying, and I think I'm going to buy into more Games Workshop as well. Okay, it looks so good. So I shall be adding two positions at this level, although I'm substantially invested, as I think you know, since last April. So we're going to do our best to use UniSearch to do all the donkey work for us. And UniSearch, I've written a very simple search, but UniSearch is an incredibly powerful tool. And we have one of our members, Mark Crittenden, who I think knows more about UniSearch than anybody else in the world. And he can make it sing and dance, but you can actually run strategies based on fundamentals and technicals. So you can find really, really great shares where the MACD has just crossed or something like that if you're a technician. I haven't got time to get into that today, but you can certainly have a great deal of fun with I'm very positive on the UK market, Ash. I think the UK market's got a very, very long way to run. It's not just me. If you read in the newspaper, you can see that American private equity companies are queuing up to buy UK stocks on the cheap. And you can see what happened to John Lang the other day. In fact, they paid a premium of nearly a third above the stock market price to get John Lang. You can see that Elliott are after GSK as well. So I think we're cheap. If we've got a red light. I think that that will come from the US, and that's why I actually covered the US in a great deal of detail and in my Monday afternoon sessions, because if there's going to be a crack come, it'll come from there. A lot of people get upset about that. They don't quite understand the sentiment that comes across the Atlantic in a nanosecond. So the American market is expensive, both on PE and relative value, very expensive. So Dr. Delito believes good portfolio management starts with buying the right stock. My word, he's 100% right. If you get the right stock that's got that wonderful combination of the ability to grow earnings safely, then you don't have that much more to do. You just want to be well out of the market and watching stop losses carefully, not buying any more stocks when the general market is falling. And we don't know when that's going to occur. And I assure you that the armies and stock market analysts and central bankers are really, really, really good at managing the last war, but not very good at managing the next one. So I can pretty much guarantee another stock comes out of the woodwork, another scare comes out of the woodwork, that it will be completely and utterly a surprise. So the parameters need to be robust, tested, and realistic. And we've tested this, our customers have tested it, and I've tested it with real lift going forward for three and a half, 4 years. And the key is relative safety, folks. It needs to be above 1.25. We want to make sure that earnings are growing, and we want that RV to be above 1.25 as well. I like to see the RS higher than 1.25. There's no doubt in some markets you struggle to get that. So we're looking for these really, really special sweet spot stocks. As I said, there's not that many of them. That's a little search that I've written. That search is on vectorVest. The stock price is greater than 50. Now, in the UK, 50 means 50 pence. If you ever use this in vectorVest US, which comes with vectorVest UK, as does Canada, Australia, and Europe, 50 means $50 in the US. In the UK, 50 is 50p. I put in a very low liquidity requirement. 50-day moving average of volume is 50,000 shares. Now, that's fine for a relatively small portfolio. If you have a big portfolio, that's a bit light. You struggle to get in and out. I will, Ramesh, I will, don't worry. One of my first mentors taught me that if you're buying £10,000 worth of shares, you would want at least 20 times that traded on average in a day. So if you're buying £10,000 worth of this company, you would want to see an average daily volume of about £200,000 go through the stock. That's a sort of a very quick rule of thumb that I've applied for a lifetime. Now, this little double R means not. So I'm looking at shares that are not on AIM. Now, quite a few of our customers have said that that's not necessary, that if the share's got a high RS, then AIM is fine. AIM is the alternative investment market. It's for smaller companies. I've excluded AIM here. The relative value should be greater than 1.25. We've discussed that. That means the share should outperform a AAA rated corporate bond by 25%. That's a measure of the future. It's a real key to vectorVest and its ability to find winners. And this little not means that it's not on a sell. And by inference, that means it's either on a buy or a hold. Now, that date that I've got here, 27th of April, was the confirmed call after the big sell-off last February. And I assure you folks that that was a difficult time to buy into stocks. know, I bought into stocks. In fact, I bought in a little bit before that using some of the shorter term vectorVest methods. And I got email after email telling me I was a complete idiot, and they were quite colorful. If you remember last April, you know, the place was closed and there was a great deal of fear around. People were killing for toilet rolls. Do you remember that? So we're using worry-free, for our worry-free investing, we're using confirm calls. These are the most conservative of all the vectorVest timing signals. They're on the front page of vectorVest, and we want to enter the market when we've got a confirmed call, and that little pointer is in the green, and the advice is saying vectorVest advises buying safe undervalued stocks that are rising in price at this time. Okay? Thank you, Carolyn. That's the vectorVest composite. And that's what it's done since last April. Now, that I haven't updated that this morning. That's into April. It was up 52% at that stage. I'm going to run it now. And that means since the COVID sell-off and the first confirmed call, that portfolio was up 54%. How many day traders have made 54%? Now, I day trade myself. In fact, I've done more day trading in the last year than I've done in the last 10, because I'm not traveling and I enjoy it. Relatively small amounts of money, but all my pension, everything I've got is in this worry-free investing methodology. And I use the short-term trades to add to that. And that's where I got the money, in fact, to buy into Persimmons, because I was fully invested, but I managed to took some out of the spread betting account, which is tax-free, as you know, and put it into the SIP account. So my longer-term stuff, and because I'm just new in the country, I've got a while to go before I hit that 1.3 million cap on the pension thing. That's since last November. And up 17%, which is 39%. Now, these do not include dividends, folks. These do not include dividends. That was the performance in 2019, up 48%. And as I say, I give 15 of that back, minus 15.5, in fact. And that was the one that that Lion Trust Asset Management, I got a big position in that. Took me a couple of hours to get out of that position end of February last year. That was a torrid morning. Everybody was selling at once. And that's the, in fact, equity curve during 2019. And in August, I was stopped out of two shares there. So in that whole period, folks, I had two trades the whole year. And then, of course, in February 2020, I had to get out of the whole thing. So if you've got a green triangle, you can relax a little bit, go on a fishing trip. If you've got a confirmed down, my word, you need to be resolute on those stops. Okay, and if I've got a red light or a red triangle, and I see the share has done nothing in the last, when there was a confirmed up in place, then I tend to raise cash on that one. If it's underperformed on the way up, the probabilities are really low that it's going to do anything when the market is falling. So I always raise a bit of cash in that, so I've got some loot ready for the next turn up. Nothing is as miserable as seeing great, great shares at great, great bargains and you've got no bloody money. So it's happened to me lots of times. So if I get out of these, and I now go to UniSearch, and that's the search, folks. It's called Long Term Where's RS Descending. I put it all in one place, but you're going to find it in under retirement. So if you go down to retirement, it's right at the bottom, just in there. Okay. So I'm going to go back now to last November. And the confirmed calls are actually, in fact, all done here for you. You said green, that means it was a confirmed call that day. So a confirmed call on the 11th of November, and that's over 6 months ago now. I run that search. As you can see, there are not that many of these shares around, folks. You get the same animals coming up over and over and over again. And if I quick test the top 10, now this is a simple linear test. We can do a much more detailed test in the back tester. Remember, a quick test looks at the price today, subtracts the price when we start, and calculates the upside. As you know, a thousand things could happen between A and B. So it doesn't tell the full story, but the back tester will tell the full story. And I'll show you how to use that or where to get the info to use that. That's what it's done. The top 10 stocks out of that have outperformed the market by, 60%? And that's a 30% annualized gain. With no losers. And that does a great deal for your old trading self-esteem, is to have no losers. If we go back to April. Here's April. And go back to there. The one that I did get stopped out of when the market was rising was Avon Rubber. If you've got a high RS stock, rarely will you get stopped out of it. But Avon I was stopped out of. And if you remember, folks, Avon was riding high on orders from the American military for gas masks. And then they had some technical problem with their gas masks, which meant that the American military sent them back, I think. As you can see, enough a lot of the there's not that many of these. Ashhead has just been awesome, absolutely awesome, riding the back of this American property boom. Howden has been great. Howden done really, really well out of the pandemic. We're stressed at home. Let's order a new kitchen. Lion Trust, asset manager with green credentials, which has done very well out of the pandemic. So if I, in fact, quick test the top 10, over the last year and a bit, it's up 51%, the market's up 31%, no losers. Look at Ashhead, 155%. My word, that's something to crow about down the old golf club, isn't it? That is 47% annualized. So the methodology works. I've been testing it for 3.5 years with real money moving forward. It's not the only shares that I've got in the portfolio. At the minute, I've got some recovery stocks in the portfolio as well. And I've got a couple of gold stocks, which are certainly far from worry-free, although polymetal is not bad in terms of RS. So I've got in the portfolio I speak about in the Monday afternoon, I've got outliers as well. But in terms of cash, 80% of my personal wealth is there. And I'm after coming from South Africa, I'm pretty much starting from 5 years ago. So that's 61. I managed to buy a flat along the way, which is really cool out of it. So if I go back, somebody asked me, Ramesh asked me to run it today. We run this today. We get Games Workshop, 3i, Computer Center, Lion Trust, Pershing Square. Now, I am shareholders in all of those. No, not 3i. I'm not a shareholder in 3i. We've got a few investment trusts here. We can filter those out by one simple line. I can put, if you don't like investment trusts, I can go stocks. Filter by industry group equal to selected industries, financial, EF. Yeah, get rid of the trusts. Okay, let's filter those. That should be not financial trusts. And I can get rid of those trusts very easily. So I've just got companies there. All right. I've got one investment trust. I've only bought one investment trust my whole life, and that's BlackRock World Mining. I see that one of the constituents of that is in trouble in Australia. It seems that BHP has in fact got a union problem because they've cut down on the Australian Miners beer allowance every day. They're only allowed 4 beers a day. And the union has gone on strike because they're only allowed 4 a day. It seems they went to the length of designing and putting in a fridge, and the fridge has only got room for 4 beers, and it's causing trouble across there. So that's my little fun story of the day. Games Workshop looks great to me. In fact, all of these look great. CCC is breaking a high as well. So Ramesh, I hope that helps a little bit. That would have been a great entry. There's the last buy signal on from the recommendations at 24. This looks to me as if it's broken out. Look at that earnings per share, folks. That's what you want. Earnings per share rising smoothly from the bottom left to the top right. And that's the COVID thing. And as you can see, it's left the COVID high. Left this high well. It's outperformed the market significantly. And if I put on my confirmed calls, that was the entry signal. And that, watch your stop losses very carefully. You weren't touched. And that has just been great. So, all right, folks. That is pretty much worry-free investing. It works. I couldn't be happier with it. I've tested this, and if I was managing your money, I would put 80% of it into worry-free investing, and the rest I would have do some swing trading. Okay. So you may be wondering how you can put this into practice. Well, this is my little sales bit. That was me trying to keep the fundamentals under control. I failed completely. I didn't have any financial training. And quite honestly, I didn't have the inclination. When I started this in 1982, when I started to trade in 1982, I was playing professional rugby. We were playing to 65,000 people every Saturday afternoon. It was a magnificent time. Played at the opening of Ellis Park in Johannesburg. There was 85,000 people in the crowd that afternoon. So the stadium only holds 65. Now they built hospitality boxes. But in those days, those hospitality boxes didn't exist, and they could put 85,000 people in. It was Transvaal against the World 15. And so in that environment, I didn't have time to fight for the books. So I became a technical trader alone. And it was only 10 or 11 years ago that I tripped over vectorVest that would simply do the fundamentals for me. So to break out, folks, I put together a way forward. And vectorVest is not a get-rich-quick scheme. You're going to have to roll up your sleeves and do a little bit of work to get on top of this. But we'll be with you every bit of the way. I'll show you why now. So I put together the Successful Investing Quick Start course, and its objective is to show you how to outperform the market in 10 minutes a night. And I've mapped it out. The first section is how to analyze any stock in 30 seconds. So that you'll be able to look at the shares that you've got, or the shares that you're thinking of buying, and sort the good from the bad. Module number 2 is all about risk and how to manage risk. Don't avoid risk, manage it. All about managing losses. So to try and minimize losses to maximize gains. Everybody says, cut your losers quickly, let your winners run. A lot more difficult to do than talk about. So in the first, we sort the good from the bad. The second, we get rid of the bad. Third section will show you when it's safe to buy back in. The fourth section is what to buy, and some cherry-picking checklists for swing trades, cherry-picking checklists for these worry-free type stocks. And then the last little bit is how to put it all together. Now, in the US, they charge a fortune for that, but we're new here. So if you roll up your sleeves and you work with me, work through it, it's £5.95, okay? vectorvest.co.uk/proven. And with the £5.95, we'll happy to throw in 60 days access to vectorvest. It's vectorvest UK, US, Canada, whole of Europe apart from Scandinavia, Scandinavia in Europe, and AU. That's the vectorVest world, the vectorVest nation. That's worth £49 on its own, folks. Now, at the end of the 30 days, if you want to stay with vectorVest, that's great. If you want not to stay with vectorVest, then you give us a shout and everything stops. As I say, we're fully authorized by the FCA. And in 11 years with vectorVest, there's never, in both the UK and South Africa, there's never been a problem with a credit card. I'll show you where the course is, Ramesh, in a second. You bear with me. And then, of course, we don't want to give you just videos. Coaching. Well, there is. I do a webcast on a Monday afternoon, which you'll be invited to. My colleague Glenn Tompkins does one on Thursday. My stuff is UK-based. His is American-based. But the techniques to invest in any market around the world with vectorVest are the same. We have a call center. It's in North Carolina, but you're going to be given an 0800 number where you can phone the call center anytime, 12 o'clock midday, 12 o'clock at night. Okay. I also run a monthly national user group, and Stan Heller, who's the managing director in Canada, runs a international user group on a Saturday afternoon, 4 o'clock on a Saturday afternoon. I think it's the first Saturday of the month, but you'll get an email about that. So we want to service you well, and we're hoping you'll be a customer for the next 30 years. And lots of people have done this. This is Tom. He's a farmer down in North Somerset. And Tom's been in the market 30 years, and he's never made a cent. He's always been buying the high tech and selling the low tech. He says he's got a written plan after all these years. I still haven't seen it, but he's getting there. And folks, if you don't think it's the best £5.95 you've ever spent, you can have it back with the greatest of pleasure. So let me show you those people who have got vectorVest. Get rid of all my things. Go to vectorVest. And go to, Ramesh, if you go to training, sir. There it is. Now, while we're here, opening in a different window, there's a navigation training series. And if I open this, it opens in a different window. There we go. And pretty much everything you need to know about vectorVest is here. It's done by Glenn Tompkins. He does a great job. That's the home page. That's the front page. One full video on the page. There's actually three on UniSearch. So how to look at the stock viewer, market timing, how to put together a watch list, the back tester, and the portfolio manager. So a huge amount of information there. So if you've got any problems, let's say with UniSearch, you've got somewhere to go, you can't sort it out there, then give the call center a call. It's free. If you can't sort it out there, then you've got me to fall back on, and Susan Thornborough at our various user groups. So we're there for you folks. So if I go back to my PowerPoint presentation, Ramesh, are you okay with that now? Where to find that? Good man. Okay, folks, that's pretty much all I've got to say. I've kept you much, much longer than I thought it would. My apologies for that. It's 5:30 here. The sun has come out, and it's time for this old fellow to go to the gymnasium. So those of you that are vectorVest customers, I'll see you on Monday afternoon. Those of you that are not vectorVest customers, if you would like to come to our Monday afternoon Q&A session, you give me an email, I'll send it through. Any of you that take our offer up this afternoon, vectorvest.co.uk /proven, it's great to have you on board, okay? And you can find me, david.paul@vectorvest.com. david.paul@vectorvest.com. So what we tried to talk about today is to let the ball do the work in the UK safer shares, and to be fully invested in the great UK safer shares that have got the ability to grow earnings strongly when the general market is rising. It's an easy prescription to building wealth. Certainly much, much easier than fighting with the noise of the market. I do that as well. I do it with relatively small amounts of money, and I add that back in to the pot. Okay, folks, thanks very much indeed. Take care of yourselves. Thank you, Ash. Thank you, Eric. I'll see you all Monday. Bye-bye.
Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe and comment your thoughts on the topic or what future videos you would like to watch. Hit the notification bell for more videos. Until next time, goodbye and stay safe.